Our next speaker will speak out about Debian adaptation to use OS for 2-year-old kids. This is Jean-Michel Philippe for Doodoo Linux. Let's applaud him.
Hello. So today I'd like to show you Doodoo Linux. I'd like to show how it looks like and how it works. But first of all, I will tell some words about the project itself to let you know what we are doing and why we are doing Doodoo Linux. Doodoo Linux is a full computer system based on Debian. The objective is to maximize the ease of use and to provide children with tools that are self-fulfilling. Basically, this is a live CD, so it is autonomous. It takes care of protecting, preserving data that may be on the computer already. It is designed by parents, and the project now is 3 years old, more than 3 years old, and we have seen more than 400,000 visitors, and we have more than 40 language teams. So today, technology for small children is coming. And it takes the form of gaming consoles, of course, tablets, TV. There are TV channels that are said to be for children from 1 or 2 years old. And the common thing between all these devices is that they are not designed to promote self-fulfilling of children, but rather to be addictive. For example, there are game software editors that hire neuropsychiatrists to make games more addictive. There is also a provision of digital entertainment, so that finally children end doing passive activities. They are in front of screens and don't do so many things by themselves. The problem is that as children will build our future, if we like too much this kind of technology, which is above all spying and kind of malware technology, our future will be built on the tools that our children like now. The objectives of Doodoo Linux, of course, is ease of use, robustness, and something that is as close as possible to the use of gaming consoles. We want to stimulate the potential of each child. We want to favor autonomy and self-confidence. We don't want that children have the impression that computers are complicated and too much complicated compared to consoles and tablets. We also want them to master technology because we live in a world in which technology is controlling almost everything. And if in the future our children are not able to master technology, they won't be able to master their own future. And of course, we want to be safe and secure for the parents to be quiet with children on their computers. So right now, we have achieved quite a good work, but we still have lots of ideas to develop. If you want to help us develop, of course, no problem, you are welcome. So we want to provide more activities for creation. We want to provide more digital contents because this is an important use of computers today. Actually, we want to show children everything that is possible to do with a computer. So of course there is internet, of course there is games, but there is also digital contents and creative activities. We would like to develop cooperation between children. We would like to develop activities that allow children to use computers as a tool in real life, for example with their toys. And why not develop the communities of children to share their experiences? So as I told you, you can help us, and there are lots of things that anyone can do to help the Linux. You have an exhaustive list here, and if you don't have time to spend and to offer to our project, you can still help by donation and goodies, and buying goodies. So now, let's look at Dodo Linux itself. When you start Dodo Linux, I'm sorry, this is the French version. You will find a menu, a main menu, that is this menu. It is organized by difficulty. For the smallest children from around 1 year or 2 years old, they see their parents on the computer using the mouse and using the keyboard, so they want to take the place of the parents, and usually they do like this with the mouse, and they do like this with the computer, with the keyboard. Most often parents are running Windows or something like that, and they immediately tell their children, no, don't do this. You are going to break something, and of course this is not the best way to be confident with computers. To address this issue in Dodo Linux, we propose a kind of learning path, starting with gamin. So when the children are really young, they can learn the mouse and learn the keyboard with this application. Now it works. So when you move the cursor of the mouse, you just have a nice draw. When you click, you have shapes that are displayed. If you press on the keyboard keys, you just have the sign which is on the key shown on the display. And usually after 1 or 2 weeks, the children understand how it works, and you can lead them to something more complicated. Yes, it's a bit slow. Next activity is around the mouse, mastering the mouse. This is indeed a set of activities. And for example, here you are taught to make a drag and drop. Of course, I always fail when I want to show. No. So it's quite simple, and when the children are quite small, this is really adapted and fitting. Where is my cursor? Yes. So in PySacache, you can learn drag and drop, you can learn to press the right and the left buttons. You can learn to make a double click. And then you can try with your children child play, which is another suite of educational games. For example, you can learn the keyboard in this game. So you have here are the figures falling down, and you have to press the correct key to make the figure disappear. And if you don't press the correct one, this doesn't do anything. So the children continue to learn the computer. Here you can use TextPaint, and then a small version of JCompris. We have removed the most complicated activities of JCompris in this one. And finally, you end with environments that are more similar to what is usually found on computers. Mini-Dudu Linux is a restricted version of 2Dudu Linux. In English, this is all Dudu Linux. So you find, again, some of the applications that were available before, plus additional applications, for example, the small cat. This is a nice game with a cat. You have to select the correct stuff to avoid that the cat get wet, because a cat doesn't like to be wet. So for this one, you have to use the tarp to block the rain, and so. So in this environment, the child is supposed to use only one tab with application launchers, and this tab is only for settings like the speed of the mouse. So instead of offering strange parameters like acceleration and speed for mouse, we just offer to set a normal a slow mouse, for example. So Dudu Linux is simple for children, but also for parents, as you can see. Finally, the most advanced activity lets children access all the applications installed in Dudu Linux. So we have the educational tab with the former applications. We have new tabs. The first one is work. And we will find a calculator, a text editor. Where is the text editor? Here. Here we have two applications to learn programming. In the first one, you have to draw something on the screen giving all commands to a turtle. In this one, you have to make an ant get out of a labyrinth, still with commands. We have put in work some additional drawing applications. MyPaint to draw with tools that look like real tools. TBO is a comic editor, so you can draw frames and then edit a frame. And put characters in frames, for example. So you can also access the internet. Unlike most of Linux distributions, we have chosen to not show the Google search page as a default, but rather to propose children to visit websites whose philosophy is quite similar to free software's philosophy. So you have a wiki, the series of wiki sites, for example. You have OpenStreetMap, OpenFlipArt Library, to get draws. There are filters, content filters, inside Dudu Linux. This is not a server on the internet that would know everything that people do on their computer. Everything is local. Web pages are filtered on their contents. Ads are removed. And we also have added a filter for JavaScript code but send personal information on servers. We have many games, maybe 30 games. We try to select games that requires to think or to elaborate strategies.
Yeah, we are running out of time, so if maybe there is some question. Okay. Let's be quick.
Just one question. It's about the selection of the package and software that you are installing in within the with the operating system. Would it be about how you make your selection for this software?
We try to select children applications that are simple enough for children, and then for parents too. We also want to show everything that is possible to do with computers. So we want to extend the panel of applications with time in order to include activities that are not yet in the Linux. Most of the time, we are using software that is already in Debian to lower the development effort. But it may happen that we need to package some extra software.
I would like to know if it is intended to have Dudu Linux running under some tablets, because it could be really cool also.
Yes, currently the stable version of Dudu Linux is still based on Debian Squeeze, but we have started to port to Debian Wheezy. And since December, our package repository has ArmHF packages and also Raspbian packages. Dudu Linux is partly running on ARM and with the fastest port of ARM. Unfortunately, we don't have tablets for testing purposes. So if you know people who would agree to give tablets to our project, you are welcome.
So how well is the language support for different languages?
It is very variable. We have maybe four or five languages for which the translations are fully completed. And around 15 or 20 languages that are between 90 and 100%. This depends a lot on translator availability, of course, and usually they don't work on the long time, on the long term, on our project.
Thank you for your talk.
You're welcome.